Good evening, viewers. Hope you all are doing truly well and also truly trying to stay safe as we all have completely sort of unlocked into the new normal. Today, of course, is our Friday when we are here with our bone muscle joint series with Dr. Ashish Arbat. As few of you know, and those who are new to the channel, True Wealth Online Health Channel is an initiative of True Wealth Integrative Healthcare, which provides integrative and personalized health and nutrition advice to guide patients and healthy individuals to overcome the health concerns and manage self-health to reach the ultimate goal of holistic health and happiness. True Wealth aims to help you separate science from hype by sharing authentic knowledge and wisdom from healthcare and nutrition stalwarts, so you can make the right health and nutrition choices. So rightly so, this series on bone, muscle, and joint, which helps educate all of us regarding a lot of things which I will be talking about soon. But a quick note before that, this True Wealth Life program is organized for education and spreading more awareness to reach the ultimate goal of health and happiness. The knowledge and experiences shared by the speaker and other participants cannot be treated as personalized consultation. For a personalized consultation and to reach out to Dr. Ashish Arbat or me for any nutrition advice, you can always call us on 9820048369 or also visit our website www.truewealth.in. You can also put your comments and questions into the live session. For example, if you're seeing it on Facebook, you can put your questions and comments in the comment boxes, and we will try to do more than justice with all the questions that you have. However, of course, we will not be talking about any or providing any specific advice on COVID-19 or related treatment on this program. So now talking about our bone muscle joint series, as I was telling you, that it is actually created to spread the authentic awareness about bone, muscle, and joint health. The various bone, muscle, joint ailments and injuries, understanding the benefits of different techniques of joint replacement and other surgeries that are needed for the bone, muscle, and joint health, and how to overcome the shortcomings, what are the parameters to consider while selecting the right technique. Also, how a right surgeon chooses right techniques with right implants for better outcomes and quick recovery. So, why is an integrative approach at the end with a specific emphasis on nutrition and physiotherapy, which is important for long-term benefits, is what we really discuss on all of our programs. And we have been having an excellent series of 12 programs with Dr. Ashish Arbat. As some of you already know and are loving his programs, Dr. Ashish Arbat is one of the first 3D robotic joint replacement surgeons in Western India. He's a consultant orthopedic surgeon at the Jahangir Hospital and the Sahyadri Hospital, Deccan, Pune. He's also practicing at the QRA Aditi Hospital and the Ruby Clinic in Kalyan, Mulund, and Thane areas. So he also really treats patients from Pune and Mumbai and a lot of other places in Maharashtra and outside. He of course has an MS from the coveted KEM Hospital. He has an MCH Ortho from the Royal College of Surgeons, UK. He is a faculty for the UK MCH Ortho course. He is he has a fellowship from the Princeton University, New Jersey, under the guidance of Dr. Jeff Abrams. And he is the first fellow under Dr. Ed Sugaya in shoulder and elbow arthroscopy. He also has a Funabashi Sports Medicine Fellowship from Tokyo, Japan. So of course he has learned so many new techniques and so much of guidance, experience from all over the world really. And he's of course associated with the IPL Gujarat Pro Kabaddi League India and Pune Wrestling Federation. He's proactively involved in devising patient information systems. He's in fact working very closely on developing these newer techniques, understanding them, training them. So that is the reason why it's apt, right, to be with him to get all the knowledge that we can on all these different surgeries and preventive treatments as well. About me, in short, I have about 20 years of global experience in nutrition formulations, continuing medical education and more. I do have a master's degree in life sciences from the Sion Hospital and an MBA degree in marketing. My career does encompass globally around therapy segments such as orthopedics, therapeutic nutrition, gynecology, gastroenterology, cardiodiabetes, and a lot more. I am, of course, the founder and CEO of True Wealth Integrative Health Centers. So it's really a proud privilege, actually, to be here with our favorite program, Bone, Muscle, Joint Series with Dr. Ashish Arbat. Dr. Arbat, welcome again. It's our Friday today, and we've been continuously running our programs, multiple episodes that, you know, you've been spending a good amount of time so that we can bring out so much of information forth to the viewers. What would you like to say to the viewers now that, you know, we are all in the new normal and, you know, you've also been started seeing more patients physically. And of course, quite a few of your patients might be waiting to come to you. And how is it going?
Fine, Rajashree. It's always nice to see you on this program and be on this program every time. And it's a nice journey for the last couple of months. I feel what you rightly said, that it's a new normal. See, who has made this new normal? People like us, who told the world that, you know, this is a disease. Yes. Imparting knowledge, even the COVID was this time, I feel media, social media, doctors, and everybody who worked for COVID, informants, scientists, and of course the ground level, we people like the police and support staff, all of us imparted knowledge, and that's what the people understood, and that's how this new normal or whatever it is that came. Similarly, we always feel that whatever is happening new in the field of medicine, surgery, orthopedics, nutrition, once we share the knowledge, it is a human right of people to know what is going on. And I guess options are very, very important. So once you get an option, that becomes very important as a human right. So that is very, very essential part of our generation. So what I feel, Rajashree, is imparting knowledge, keep on imparting knowledge, and let the people choose the right thing for themselves. And that's what we are doing on these platforms. So today we have got something extremely new in the field of orthopedics and this robotics and what we are doing, and we are spreading the message. And luckily we just got an award from the coveted Jahangir Hospital for performing the highest number of joint replacement last 2 months consistently, even in this COVID era. And I thank my patients, my team, for supporting us and believing in us. And thank you to Jahangir Hospital also for being with us in these times and providing us for whatever is necessary. So this is new. So we are getting back. People are getting out on their own, getting treated. It was COVID. Now other diseases were taken aside. But life moves on, Rajashree. And I think we are at least 60 to 70% back on track.
So really getting back to the subject for today, I mean, osteoarthritis is something which is so very common. And, you know, you see that every household, you know, you will find at least one person, one of the, especially the older people having osteoarthritis. And then there are, you know, different types of surgeries. And of course, on our programs, you have addressed total knee replacement, partial knee replacement, knee osteotomy surgery, the knee arthroscopy, which also you've spoken about. Last time we spoke about also about the cartilage repair and restoration. So we really covered so many different topics. But today again, you know, every time though we have spoken so much, you have so much newer to tell us. So what really, I mean, if you could explain to the viewers a little about what osteoarthritis is really, and you know, how do we really choose the right type of surgery, knee surgery?
So Rajeshree, like every time we are adding new, and last time we had talked about cartilage transfers and many newer techniques that have come. So basically I'll just share the screen with like every time.
Yes.
So I hope it is seen.
Yes.
So this is we are specialized in robotic joint replacements, and not only the metal part of it, we are doing bio joint replacements also, like regrowing the cells and making a bio implant and implanting in because every time surgery doesn't mean that a metal goes inside. Every time surgery doesn't mean that you replace the whole joint. So a lot of engineering considerations, a lot of biotech considerations are also in consideration of this. So this is us. And these are the places that we work. Sayaji Hospital, Jahangir Hospital in Pune, and Cure Hospital in Thane. So basically arthritis, Rajesh, if you can see the video, like every time I show that osteoarthritis, yes, is a part. Now see this cartilage here.
Yes.
Whenever this cartilage goes, any joint, all our joints are covered with this cartilage, this white structure here. And whenever it goes, there are around 500 reasons for it to go. And Rajeshree, osteoarthritis is a disease which is there since Homo sapiens stood erect. From Homo erectus, it's a 10 million you have mummies which are millions of years old, and they have this arthritis changes, and it is an old disease. It is genetically there in us, and the problem is cartilage never grows back in the mammals ever when it is lost. So that's the reason the only option when it goes is to either do some surgical technique like cartilage transfer or a partial knee replacement or a total knee replacement. And the newer techniques are focused on all these things. So here, if you can see, so this is how it gets lost. And then we grade it, grade one, grade two, this is moderate. Then it comes to severe grade. And then when it is completely lost like this, this is severe osteoarthritis. So that's what you're asking. So now our focus is to replace, resurface these kind of osteoarthritis with the latest techniques. And the techniques nowadays are focused, at least when we are there, is to save as much as possible. That is the ligaments in the body, the muscles, and adding newer techniques like the robotics that we do, the RoboAlign, the 3D robotic plannings, and a lot of stuff where patients are benefited with the modern techniques of anesthesia, modern techniques of minimally invasive surgery, early discharge, early back to work, and results which last for more than 40 years.
That's great. And again, as usual, your video and the slides are very easy to follow for the viewers. So really appreciate you sharing that and explaining that. At times, you know, there are things which you are explaining to us over and over again, but we really appreciate them. The other part then we really come to is, you know, when patients are suffering something like this, how do you really determine what sort of a procedure that you should go, should the patient really undergo, and you know, what outcomes really the patient should expect out of it?
Rajeshri, again, patients come down to us with bad X-rays. See, here, when they come with this kind of stage, you know, grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, we have already talked about grade 1 and grade 2, where we are doing cartilage transfers and a lot of stuff which we do, which we are now more focusing on nutrition with regrowing your cartilage and putting it back. But when you come to this stage 4, where your cartilage is lost up to the bone, that's where we talk about replacements. And in replacements, there are near about sixth generation. We are in the sixth generation of replacement. It started 70 years back. But as the cars grew, the watches grew, now we are in the rocket science and the robotic era, where we are doing lot and lot of new stuff, where patients can be literally discharged in 24 to 48 hours, and they are back to their super activities, which we'll be sharing now. And
yes,
today we are talking about something known as a partial knee replacement, wherein the patient gets the benefit of only 2 to 1 or 2 inches of incision, no muscle cutting, and just a partial kind of a knee replacement we are discussing today in grade 4. So what happens, Rajeshri, it has been found world over that people are advised joint replacement. This was the old kind of joint replacements, where they used to replace everything, the total joint replacement. Now, as time went on, and I keep on explaining my patients that today is the era of gait analysis, keeping the joint as normal as possible. So what is normal is to save whatever nature or God or anybody has given to us, that is saving all the ligaments, saving all the muscles. And what is found, Rajeshri, in this grade 4? This is the medial side, madhli bazu, beech mein wali side, this inner side. Our natural stance, if you see our natural stance in this picture, our natural stance, we are having maximum weight on the medial side of the knee. Matlab manje madhlya bazula. And here, and it is found out that 40 to 50 to 60% of people have maximum osteoarthritis in the medial side, and either and severe pain on the medial side. That's how he starts. And if we can halt the disease at that point, you will never require a total joint replacement. And that's where the concept of partial joint replacement, or something like this. If only the medial part is gone, we just resurface the medial part with robotic planning, and you will see the results. It is a very, very minimally invasive surgery. It's a very specialized, very, very specific procedure. And literally, it is a 4 to 5 centimeter of part that goes in up and down. And literally, the patient never even feels that he has got a surgery done. And the pain and the factor and the deformity just vanishes. And he has to never come back for a total knee replacement ever. So patients who come down in this category, mostly it's more than 45. And the younger people, where they want to do a lot of activities and they want to do most of the sitting, squatting kind of activities. And that's where we use this partial knee replacement.
That was again a lot of important inputs again that came from you. The question which normally people ask, it's always a common question, and I'm sure you have so many testimonials to share that'll nullify that, is that people are worried about if there are any possible complications, or if there will be any pain that they will feel through the surgery.
Yeah, so share the video of what we do in the partial. So
yes,
actually, if we can.
Yeah, that will really help to understand.
Share the thing is, now we can see this knee, and so this is the only part that is worn out, and that's the only part we resurface. We are not touching any of the ligament. There are only small three parts. There are zirconium, cobalt chrome, titanium, niobium nitride, gold, a lot of stuff I'll be showing. And that's the only part that we replace. See, this is a kind of arthritis. People come in 60% of the times.
Yes.
And that's what we replace. And only a small part, a very, very small incision is taken. And literally the patient goes home within the first 24 to 48 hours. It's hardly 4 inches incision. And if I can share the PPT to you, and what we do is many a times we can do arthroscopy, see whether the joint is gone bad. It's a keyhole kind of a procedure. And then we choose to do this partial after the robotic planning. So what we do, normally I have shown you the x-rays, and once the patient comes with such kind of arthritis, we do a lot of robotic planning in the three dimension. Every time, these are our robots. And in the robotic planning, the robo align, we do a CT scan of the patient. Now we're talking about grade 4 arthritic patient who come for, they have been advised for total joint replacement. They can come and take our opinion whether we need a total or a partial. When they come to us, we ask them for a specialized CT scan in our center. Most of our centers have in-house, and that is loaded in our robotic planning arm, robo align, and we get a three-dimensional artificial intelligence image of the complete joint of the patients. There are around 50 points that we check how much correction is required, how much arthritis is there, various implants. And this is how the robo shows us what is the correction required. And once the planning is done, we even plan the implant and a partial kind of a knee replacement is done. Now, you are asking about the question of pain. So Rajesh, yes. Our team does painless and stitchless procedures.
Yes.
In the painless procedure, we have this kind of sonography, very high grade machine. And in that machine, we just give blocks to the supplying nerves, which last for 5 to 6 hours. There is no anesthesia or any general anesthesia given. Patient is totally conscious, pain-free, absolutely relaxed during the procedure. There is a special tourniquet here, which a single drop of blood doesn't go. And after that, we have stitchless procedure where there are no stitches on the skin. There is something we use known as a Dermabond Prineo from Johnson & Johnson and other companies. And there is a special glue that we paste with a mesh. So there is no stitches, no suture removal. Patient goes home without any stitches. Internal also there are only. So these are the latest techniques, Rajeshree. So it's a painless, stitchless, very less stitch and a partial knee replacement kind of a procedure. And this is something part of the robotics that we go inside the OR and replicate. And this is how the robo shows us a lot of corrections and in the operation theater. And it's a completely artificial intelligence based knee replacement. And I'll show you, this is how it is seen. Wow. This is a partial knee replacement. Mm-hmm. I have only put a golden cap. I have not taken down any muscle, any ligament, nothing. And this is the part that I was talking about, a partial, very, very small part. And on day zero, on the table, look at the movement. So beautiful movements. It completely corrected. This is a robotic image of the patient on table. And that's how it is seen. And see how look at the activities the patients can do. That we'll be talking about. I'll show you some videos at a partial knee replacement patient, how they do, what activities they can do. But sitting down, cross-legged, doing Indian activities becomes a regular affair because it is just such a small part that goes in. And within I'll show you, we make the patients stand within the first 4 hours of surgery.
Yeah.
Because it's a stitchless and painless procedure. We make the patient walk the next day if he's all okay. Within 18 hours, the patient goes 1,000 kilometers to see us, and we send them back driving back to their hometown in a car, or they need no ambulance and a lot of stuff. Look at this post-operative within 3 weeks. There's so many patients. Now, this is a unicondylar patient. And look at the activity. Moved the dressing, the second week of surgery, remember that he has gotten surgery done. It's such a beautiful procedure. We need to have a good bone mass. You have to come, the physiologically they are very strong. They need these in their life and they really benefit from this. And I would suggest that the most of the Europe, most of the Western countries are moving towards the partial knee replacement. And now it is available in India and we are doing very, very successful partial knee replacement with our robotics.
Thank you very much for actually sharing those many inputs when it comes to these latest techniques and the amount of research and you described the different metals that go into it, into making it perfect for the patients is so very important again. And it's great to understand that. And also apart from the fact, I think, most of my questions, which I was really that had come from some of our viewers, and I was going to understand, ask you, were really addressed that when it, of course, the pain quotient, people are worried about how much time will it take for recovery.
Adding to the pain question, we are especially my team. It's not that everybody can give a pain free thing, because it is a collective team effort. For the pain, we particularly are very, very focused on painless procedure. In that, what we mean, I showed you that we do sonography blocks. Second thing, there are certain new drug delivery system like morphine patches. We hate to give patients the painkillers, We hate to give that. If you see in my post-operative prescription, the painkiller is SOS, that is if required. Then during the procedure, we give something known as a local block in the ligaments, in the nerve supplying there. The surgeon also gives it and the anesthetist under sonography gives it preoperative. So most of the pain factor, it is known as presumptive pain management. That is, we manage the pain before even touching the patient, and that's how it works. And once the procedure is done, that the medicine locally has taken it over, the brain doesn't even understand that, body has any pain. See, pain is very, what we study about pain. Pain is a subjective phenomena and pain is abstract. You feel the pain. You don't get pain. You feel the pain. Understand my words.
Yes.
So you get a boil or you get a scar, but you feel the, you don't feel a scar. You feel the pain.
Correct.
So pain, if the perception of the brain is changed, so we do it preoperative. All this is done preoperative. Matlab operation zhalyavar painkiller vagare det nahi ami. Operation cha adhich, the whole area is made such that the nerves, the brain is completely subjudiced against that pain. The brain doesn't understand that there is pain. And that's the reason patient starts walking within the first day of surgery.
Totally. So that really addresses most of the issues that patients normally come up with. And, they are worried about how much will be the recovery time, because that's, again, something which you emphatically, make sure that patients are out of the hospital spoon. They're on their feet as early as possible. In fact, you may get them on the feet on day zero itself. So those are all remarkable inputs and, reassuring for patients, really.
So again, that's a good question. See, pain. Now, out of 10, there is one person that after all these efforts, they might have pain. And who are those people? These are normally the obese or very, very old women who have very, very less threshold for pain. There is a psychological element that I will get pain no matter what. Those category of patients can have some this thing of pain. The patients who are having issues like diabetes, severe diabetes uncontrolled, and very weak muscles, the fat in the muscles, those are some category which can have 20 to 30% of pain. But 99% of patients, especially the males, healthy females, active females, we counsel them before the procedure that, you know, you have to do activities. And I have seen the patients who are really having good threshold of pain,
yeah,
are not afraid. They believe the surgeon, they believe the procedure. They never, ever complain of pain.
Yes.
Pain is very subjective and it's very, very psychological. So like they say, Shakespeare writes, madman doesn't have pain. If you hit a madman who is having schizophrenia, walking on the road, you hit him or something, he doesn't feel pain. Because again, I'm saying pain is a feeling. If I want to feel pain, I will feel pain. If I don't want to feel pain, I will not. But we'll make it sure that this procedure is stitchless and painless.
Yeah. So that's another thing, the stitchless and painless aspect, which people do need to understand, that it sort of makes the post recovery very fast, and also you're trying to preserve as much as we can from the skin to the tissue to the cartilage and the bone. And the other thing, though, people normally again land up asking is, you know, what will happen if I put off the surgery for another year or so, you know, because people are still a little bit anxious right now about the
so what happens
COVID,
is
but what you rightly said, that you know they need to trust the surgeon, and if you do that, then the outcomes
now
are
putting
so
off,
much
there
more
is,
better.
One of my very, very close friends, she's doing a research on something called as why the Asians have there's a PhD somebody's doing on procrastinating. What is procrastinating? That Asians, there's a history that in Asia, not only India, Asia, the Chinese, us, the whole Asian crowd, even the Middle East, we have a genetic programming of delaying things. Must be because of our slave history or lack of resources history in the recent times. And we have this thing of delaying things. So if you delay it, now understand, your middle side is completely worn out. You are taking 4,000 average steps per day. Average, an old person walking in the home takes 2,000 to 3,000, 4,000 steps. Now, unnecessary, you are going to damage the patella. You're damaging the other side. And in that gait, the waddling gait that you get, you're taking some funny painkillers or some any other pathy or something that will elevate the pain, but cartilage is not going to come. So your basic disease remains. Your other side, you are unnecessarily screwing up. And third thing, your spine gets most of the brunt. So the lumbar spine starts getting larger and thicker, and something known as lumbar canal stenosis comes. So Rajeshri, 70% of people who delay have got arthritis in the other compartments of the knee. They lose all the ligaments, which we want to save, because the ligaments get mucoid degenerated. They lose the muscles. They become fatty degenerated muscles. And they lose the spine. 70% of the people who delay surgeries internationally, 67% people have got spine surgeries also. So we have to understand that the base of the body is the knee. Once we make it equal, so what is doctor doing is the loss, only the loss cartilage he's placing and making the knee straight with robotics, so that he will never need any spine surgery, any hip surgery. One joint above, one joint below will always and always get damaged. And the spine, literally 70% out of 10, 7 people will have spinal degeneration, which is completely avoidable, because spine surgeries, believe me, there is no pain-killing mechanism for spine. There is no robotics for spine. A spine surgery remains a complicated surgery till now. So you can avoid that. So those who are delaying, understand your hip, your ankle, and your spine. Don't just think about the knee. You are an erect structure.
Yes.
And other part, you become a coward.
Well, and people need to understand
you become
the later.
A coward, you labeled a coward, and you don't do any activities. You don't go out. You are in pain. You don't play. You don't be yourself. You don't drive. Yeah, though the person wants to live this kind of life, just existing, not just surviving, not existing. So you need to survive, you need to be somebody, अपना वजूद होना चाहिए. एंड दोज काइंड ऑफ पीपल आर इन द कैटेगरी, दे आर नोन एज कोपर्स. दोज पीपल वी टेल गो फॉर अ पार्शियल नी रिप्लेसमेंट, एंड मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर एजुकेटेड पीपल, मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर पीपल ऑफ वेरी वेरी एक्टिव, वेरी मच्योर पीपल. हु आई हैव सीन पीपल हु डिले दिस काइंड ऑफ प्रोसीजर्स आर लेस एजुकेटेड. वी हैव टोटल नी आफ्टर दैट एंड अंडरस्टैंड. आर वेरी अफ्रेड काइंड ऑफ पीपल who have never been on themselves for a lot of time. So this procedure registry, as of now, you see the worldwide, it is mostly done by the CEOs, the high demand people. Whatever my unicorn dollar patients are, the most of them are the very, very educated males and females. They understand the gist of life. And the other patients who are really believers. In between category, the waiting category, are pushing themselves to a total knee replacement, and the problems of the total knee replacement, and the psychological aspect to keep on experimenting with your body with some white tablets, yellow tablets, this churna, that churna, but the right. organ is gone. The organ is gone. When the organ is gone, it is not going to come back.
Well, so rightly said. I mean, people really need to understand that earlier the better that we do it, so that once it goes to the grade fours, it's even going to increase the chance of total knee replacement. And we are seeing that in the Western world, people try to, and just as you mentioned, the CEOs and the people in upper management who really believe in staying fit. So much is, you know, those are the people who are going with it. And in the Western world, it has become a norm these days that, you know, people go ahead with these surgeries much
the
earlier.
The latest to add in the bigger names is Shoaib Akhtar, the bowler. He's got a partial knee replacement and he's coaching Pakistan. He's playing. Andy Murray, he's playing. Sir Kapil Dev, partial knee replacement, he's playing. Hema Malini, she's dancing. So these people... are very, very active people. I have a lot of my own celebrity patients who are builders and who are lawyers, who are doctors. Because these people, army people, I've operated 3 colonels because I'm from Pune. So I've got a lot of army people coming to me and they're really, really happy with those procedures because they are able to do all the activities that they were doing 20 years back without even thinking, I've got a knee replacement done, what should I do? Because they don't feel it. They just back to normal.
We do have comments coming from the patients on our platform as well that, you know, it's a very good, explained in a very very easy way and showing the reality. And of course, you know, showing it with your videos, like I keep commenting that they are
videos.
Very...
If I have time, then
yes,
I'll
course.
Show you some maximum result for the people. And I guess...
So again, in this kind of technique, which is quite new and which is done a little, which can be done early, do you also see patients who need a revision or there are any failed surgeries beforehand?
See, partial knee, partial knee replacement is again a very, very specialized field. Now, partial knee replacement is to be done by surgeons like us who are doing high volume. You know, so
yes.
When we were like 6, 7 years back, we never did partial because we used to not do those numbers and that kind of options we did not have. It really requires, at least you should finish 1,000, 2,000 joints under your hands. Now we are more than 4,000 joints in our hands. That we need to have that criteria of as a surgeon who can do a partial knee replacement. Every surgeon is not able to do a partial knee because it's a very technical procedure. Because Rajeshri, whatever becomes small, see if you make a MacBook Pro small, you know, so it's whatever becomes small with that expertise becomes a complex procedure. So it's a complex procedure. You need to have robotics planning and that kind of stuff with you. You need those gadgets. You need those tie up with those companies who make these particular implants. And you need to be really trained. We have specially taken training after so many joints that I've special been trained. So I was trained in the US and I went special training for Unicondala to Germany and Spain in Madrid, where we had workshops of partial knee. After that time, we were 2000 joints down. So the surgeon who is doing high volume is the surgeon you should choose. The surgeon who is doing it robotically, you should choose, and you should have enough volume of unicondylar knees under your belt so that you can give results. Because yes, unicondylar in new hands can engineeringly fail. It is a very sophisticated procedure. And now that we proudly can tell that we have no failures, at least in the last 100 unicondylars. Other numbers are less, Rajeshree, because most of the patients in India come in the grade 4 plus, 5 plus, where you complete all the condyles are destroyed. Correct. Now the patients are reaching us, you know, and, or they come by luck, you know, a person who's very conscious about himself, he comes and says, come on. So that's the reason I'm telling, very, very educated people are reaching. But there are a lot of farmers whom I have done this procedure.
Wow.
There is, I'll show you one video of a army man who I did it procedure, and look at the activities that he does. Last time also I had showed you the maximum results. And
well, just a quick comment. I mean, that's the reason why, you know, these kind of programs that we are doing relentlessly again and again sort of helps reaching it to more and more people, because every time we do it on 6 different platforms, trying to reach as many different type of people every time. So so also it brings us to the question that, you know, choosing the right surgeon, which we keep talking about. So, you know, it was interesting that you told us that otherwise we wouldn't know that, you know, it needs very specialized technique, and the patient should reach.
And Rajesh, I was humble enough, because I told you before finishing 1000 joints, we were afraid of, and believe me, that is again a huge number, because there are surgeons who are doing 2 or 3 joints a year because they are more into trauma. And because I've seen my own initial, after doing so many joints, because I was always in a high volume, I was in Fortis, Lokmanya, and now I'm in Jahangir, Sayadri. We have high volume centers ever I have worked in Apollo also. So even then, unicondylar is a procedure, or a partial knee is a procedure, where we have to choose the patient and the patient has to choose us. So I'll show you some unique results of our maximum results of a patient, you know, a unicondylar. I'm very proud of this patient. And he comes with similar kind of medial arthritis here, and see, the other side is quite okay. And we did a partial knee replacement to him, and with the latest robotic techniques that I showed. And this is his, again, I had showed you this partial knee for him, you know, this movements on table, and this is his x-rays. And look at the activities, Rajeshree, that this I had shared once maximum result, and look at the activities that he does post-surgery. This is never possible with a total knee replacement, if you do understand now. And, you know, activities like yoga and a lot of stuff, where even once I had showed you that a modern techniques can give you all these activities.
Yeah.
And this was never ever seen after a total knee. So you can lead an absolute normal life, and he's leading a supra normal life. And look at the activities that he can do. And I don't know why he does this, but he does this. I won't advise it, but you see, this is all the activity. You can go to the gym, you can share, you can have a modern married life, you can drive, you can do all the activities. See, that is a lot of questions people ask. Can I enjoy a married life after that? Females ask. And can I have, you know, various that kind of pleasures that a married life associates? But yes, you can do all those activities. And partial knee can do real miracles, because it's hardly only a small part of, you know, like I am replacing like a tooth, you know, not the complete teeth, the tooth. So I'm replacing that with complete modern technology. And the white paper for the sledge that I'm using from Link is near about 40-45 year old survival. So if the surgeon places it well, somebody comes, you see, there's a common question that the doctor said, maji dusri side, mera dusra side kab kharab hoga, aur mujhe total nahi kabhi lag sakta hai. So I tell him, my friend, you're now 50.
Yes.
you have got this arthritis in 50 years, so at least you need more 40, 45 years for the other side, or say 30 years by the time you'll be 90. And God forbid, how many people survive till there. So once you do a partial, it's for life, technically.
So that sort of also I would like to ask another question is, when we see that kind of recovery happening, also how much is, you know, a physical or a physiotherapy important after this kind of a procedure? Does it take too long months of it? Also, is there any, you know, role that nutrition also plays? Because I know you have a very team approach when it comes to looking at your patients right from when they approach you with this kind of a condition to going through surgeries and then the post-surgery management.
Rajashree, in the partial knee, there is something called two things we do. We give up, we have to, there are criteria that are fellows or our students, they take down. There are criteria. The muscle has to be good. You have to be at a particular weight. You know, every person coming and telling me I'm 120 kilos and I need a partial, we won't do it. You should be in that age, in the particular weight criteria. Your weight should not be more than 90 kilos or say 100 kilos. You should have good muscle mass if you have that kind of weight. Your bone stock has to be really good, that we check on the x-rays. And preferably we do it in the males because the bone stock is good. You have to have no other side arthritis at all. That we check with the CT scan and the robo. And you have to have something known as, we really give them pre-operative physio so that the person gets some nice muscles, like it's for a week or something. And we treat them after that procedure. And you need to have no deformity more than 20 degrees. One more thing, if you have got a ligament surgery done and the ligaments are lax, or you have an absent ACL or a PCL, we cannot do partial. So if you have some worn out ligament and you have never been bothered about it and you get an arthritis, even a medial arthritis with a broken ACL, I cannot do a partial knee replacement. I have to do we do those anatomical knee replacements, and those are also beautiful. But partial, it is a selected criteria. So you ask me, Rajashree, out of 100, how many people you do partial? Must be 20.
Yeah. But the good part is that people, especially professionally, people who are exhausting their cartilage and their knees have this kind of a procedure at to scavenge them and help them do that early on, and then they can really stretch up to 40, 45 years. Isn't that really amazing? I mean, such a great procedure that we have. A couple of other questions again, you know, going back, of course, you know, one, of course, pertaining to nutrition, and I'm going to give a quick inputs on it. But the other thing is also people keep talking about infections. So, that's another worry.
Every time I get this question.
Yes. And I like to emphasize it because, you know, that's something which people either don't know about, otherwise they know too much about. So, you know, one of those...
Nobody knows too much about. What we can say is nobody knows that infection essentially is 80% of the time hospital oriented. So if you choose a wrong operation theater, a very slow surgeon, a surgery which lasts for more than 2 hours by a surgeon, which we finish this procedure in 20, 25 minutes, Rajashree, once we start it. The operation theater has to be internationally in the category. So for me, it is not an issue because I operate in one of the best operation theaters in the world now, both Sahyadri and Jahangir, and they have beautiful operation theaters. And even in... I don't go to any center and I don't do anywhere else because that is one of the requirements. And infection, for the last 800 cases, I have one or two infections, and those infections were urinary tract infections after 8 months or 9 months. So post-surgery, if you have some diabetic infection, tooth infection, or urinary tract infection, only those patients you need to see something. I had one patient who had a skin infection after 6 months of surgery because of psoriasis. That we had to revise. But most of the infections that I see is because of a bad center or a new surgeon doing, just for the sake of doing in a unprivileged operation theater. So you have to choose your center very, very wisely. You have to choose your surgeon, because this remains a specialized job.
Great. So I think I am on this point going to give a few quick inputs as to, you know, being also a part of your team when it comes to giving them nutrition advice.
Yes, nutrition. I've seen, Rajeshji, I'll add it very, very honestly.
Yes.
People who are, I'm not promoting anything. It's a scientific opinion, who are heavy on protein diets.
Yes.
The diets that you provide, they are regular on their vitamin checks, like you always say, and who are into non-vegetarian diet, who are into regular collagen diet with non-veg. I'm not against vegetarian, but most of the people who own vegetarian not take supplements also. I have seen recovery is massive in patients who are regular exercisers and on non-vegetarian diet. They are really, really resistive to pain. They resist. Their recovery is fast. And of course, you are going to add your value added. So most of the patients, I think last 4 years, all of my patients have received your flexi food as a thing. And I think we are coming down with a paper that they are recovered so fast that I don't have to even ask them to do any extra activities, because the combinations that you give in flexi food are massive add for the enzymes that you provide and the whole package with Fortifood. I am very, very happy. There's nothing promotion in this, but the collagens and a lot of herbal stuff that you give, which you discuss, yes, are really helping my patients. And that is the first and last requirement. When the patient comes for follow-up on discharge, he takes those orange kits with him for the next 3 to 4 months. And I am not bothered. No infection, nothing. Once he takes those supplements, the surgery becomes a boon to him or her.
Yeah, so unlike every time, this time even I am going to speak on the same lines and showcase a couple of those products, because again, like, you know, there's nothing promotional about it, but we've seen it is helping patients, and patients do need to understand what they should go through. So a few slides on that, because again, it is something which we are doing for the patients so that they recover well, and, you know, they're also going to be able to help themselves from getting, you know, further knee issues again. So, of course, when they're going out, we highly recommend, you and I both believe in protein diets, and it is extremely important so that the muscle health and bone health both is taken care of. This is very important these days. Sarcopenia is something which is muscle loss in simple words, is becoming such a big concern. And that sort of also results in putting more pressure on our knees. And so getting a good protein diet and a mix of it with non-veg, when it comes to chicken, fish especially, and dairy, which is going to be milk, yogurts, cheese, and eggs, again, something which we both, you know, emphatically talk about, but also plant proteins, which can be taken in the form of different pulses that we eat, nuts that we can eat. So again, a good plan which is given for the day long, so that they know that their proteins are spaced out and they're able to digest them. But again, how much of protein is one thing, but also what quality of protein, what type of amino acids does the protein break down into? Because as Dr. Albert mentioned, even their infections or recovery from a standpoint that the cell recovery, so that cell recover well, and also the immune function is better. What type of proteins is important. So, which is why he's mentioned, we do have a product called Fortifood. Now, it includes proteins which give isoleucine, leucine, valine, glutamine, and arginine. And this really helps us enhance the recovery. The recovery is faster and also neater, and also correcting the vitamin mineral deficiencies. This can actually be done pre-surgically and post-surgically both. This helps good uptake of all the nutrients and also the different biochemical processes in our body, so that the recovery is much faster. So this is important. Normally we all eat erratically. We don't eat balanced food. So it is important to correct the deficiencies, and getting a combination which has everything in it, which has essential proteins, vitamins, minerals, and also antioxidants in the right, in the right formulation, the right composition, the right quantity is extremely important. These proteins then break down into amino acids, which we normally know gives us energy, but also builds the muscle. But fourth dimension is also really the bones. So for bone formation also, it is extremely important. So considering that, enzymes are important out here because proteins break down into amino acids with the help of enzymes. So another product which we talk about, but I highly recommend taking a supplementation when it comes to enzymes. You all fall short of enzymes. So no matter how much good we eat, if it is not digested and assimilated well, if the uptake of nutrients doesn't happen well, the recovery will not be as, it will not be as good. It's good for the recovery as well as for our future health. And the most important thing, which Dr. Arbat and I always keep talking about is, having a balance. I keep recommending balance in alkaline and acidic diets, because again, inflammation is something which is very, very notorious in our body. And this is the one which is aggravating the osteoarthritis, especially people who get it early as well. So keep the chronic inflammation and oxidative stress, which is notorious diseases that happen in our body, and this is how the cell gets damaged, like the apple is getting damaged. So, but we have to go on the other way around path, and you can see that inflammation is affecting all the organs and especially aggravates arthritis in our body. So there are so many natural anti-inflammatory ingredients which can be used, because we all need inflammation in our body to keep it's an immune function which keeps our body safe from so many toxins and so many bacteria and viruses. But at the same time, the natural anti-inflammatory agents can keep the excessive inflammation under control. These anti-inflammatory ingredients can be taken for a longer period also. So highly recommended, especially people for whom who are going through a partial knee replacement, because they intrinsically do have inflammation in their body, which needs to be controlled. So after a partial knee replacement, they will actually not need any more surgeries and they can really live well with it. So something which has the widest anti-inflammatory action is, which is FlexiFood. And really so many of our patients like Dr. Arbat mentioned, some of the doctor patients as well are extremely happy with this formulation. It has ingredients which are from modern research and are ancient insights. So collagen, glucosamine, vitamin C, which is important, gurgul is important. We have heard about turmeric, ginger, rosehip, also ashwagandha these days. So this really makes it a very good synergistic combination, and can help, these ingredients can really help in the further damage to the organs. So that was in short from me, Dr. Arbat, today. But this is exactly what we do in practice. I just wanted to bring that forth. Furthermore, of course, if there are any other videos which you would want to share, but otherwise
finished an hour and we don't know how the hour goes.
Because
one thing we have to understand is all this, it's a combination of teamwork. It's not that I have a team of 5-6 people, all of you including 8 people that consistently stand by me, who are working around the clock. I am now not at the receiving end of a lot of stuff, because my anesthesia team, my personal team, our clinical coordinator, our clinical director, you, my Mahesh, and a lot of people, Ritesh, my marketing team, a lot of people are involved in this, the physiotherapy part, and more to it, the staff that we work, because all are not tuned with the high volume that we are doing, and it takes effort from every side, the humanitarian side, the scientific side, the social side. So we have now reduced the cost of our joint replacement to the least. So there are certain areas where we have worked, we are getting generic medicines, and there are some surgeries that we are doing the lowest in Maharashtra, the cost wise, with the same quality, with the same passion, and people should take the benefit of it. Then we have camps and we have special rates for this upcoming Diwali, and a lot of poor people have been benefited. And Rajeshri, I don't bother whether the patient is a very, very rich Mediclaim patient or whether he comes from a very poor background. We have it is near about 40% of patients we really do in charity. I'm associated with a lot of these kind of organizations. So many patients from a lot of Nagar Sevaks and all come, and we really do it at the same passion with the same result. They should just get the benefit of it. And
well, we saw that very evidently when we did the show with two sports people, and they came forth saying that, you know, how they were so worried about it, about the expense part of it, when they were not celebrities. Today they are celebrities, but they were, in fact, both of them were indebted to you for, you know, doing those surgeries in time for them.
It is imperative that we have to understand the law of the land. You say, no, India remains a socially deprived country, and if these techniques are available even to the poor people, we'll be more than happy, and we are more than happy. I said initially that educated people are taking. See, we are doing a lot of joint replacements, touch wood, but the partial, the newer techniques, we are making available to the common man as well. And they should take the benefit of it. It should not. Why I added is most of the educated people come to us for a partial. I guess they reach out to us early. The poor people are not reaching out to us early. Even they understand that they want to not to do a total knee later on. They should go for a partial knee or this kind of stuff at the same rate. And this is where I feel that our program should reach that masses also, Rajeshri.
Yes, and I think in and out, we really keep making that effort to reach more and more people, and why we are doing these programs, taking out so much of time, and you take out so much of time every week. And, you know, it takes a lot to be consistent, especially in these times where now you're doing so many surgeries, and, you know, the COVID fear is still there. So, you know, you have to take additional efforts to keep everything safe for them. And through this, we are still keeping on doing what we are, just to be able to reach out to maximum number of people. And we are very happy, True Wealth is very happy to be associated with you and taking all these educational sessions ahead. And we will keep doing so till as much as we can. And the newer techniques, every time that you come up and explain them easily is in a very easy language is great. So as usual, it's been a pleasure to really be with you on this program today. And we will be back, of course, with a new topic next week. Thanks for taking out the time. And if there are any, you know, any concluding remarks that you would want to sort of make and takeaways for the viewers before we close this program.
As usual, thanks, Rajesh. And thanks for your platform. Again, closing remarks, life is moment, and if you can live on your, you know, it's better to live on your legs than to die on your knees. So be active, be healthy. Whatever comes in the way of being active and healthy, just correct it and move on. So we can be a part of your journey of your life, and let us help each other so that we grow, all of the India becomes a healthy country again.
Well, what a statement to say that, live on your legs and die on your knees. Love that. And I think on that statement, really, we keep the momentum going. And I think we all should now come out of the fear and go back and chase our dreams, really. And yes, of course, collaborate and work together for each other and for improving health and happiness for all of us. So on that note, we end today's program. And of course, I am going to extend my thanks to RSG Energia and Mahesh Dharade's team, who are back end and never seen, but they're always putting in relentless efforts, taking our programs to several different groups, seven different platforms, so that it reaches to major number of people. And they're always researching newer ideas how this can reach to more people. And they design flyers, and they're a part of creating this series extensively. So I'm just going to play a small promo of RSG Energia, again, where people can look into this to be able to access the products like Fortifood and Flexifood, which are extremely useful for the patients.